Assalamualaikum. This video is for class 9. Today I am going to explain you about the Metternich and his system. This is the concluding part of chapter 3, that is the 19th century of Europe. Metternich's full name was of Clemens von Metternich. He was born in 1773 in Germany. He was one of the dominant personalities of contemporary Europe. Metternich was the Chancellor of Austria for a span of 40 years from 1809 to 1848. Unless diplomats, he was known as the Paris Prince of Diplomacy. Fischer, a historian, calls the period from 1815 to 1848 as the age of Metternich. His political opinions were influenced by three ideas. First, reintroduction of the political system prevalent in Europe in the pre-revolutionary era. Secondly, blocking the French Revolution generated democratic, liberal and nationalist ideologies. Third, keeping Australian interests intact as well as maintaining his supremacy in Europe. These three policies adopted by Metternich, known as the Metternich system in history. Nationalist voices were severely suppressed. The universities were brought under the strict government control. Number three, the liberal students and professors were imprisoned. Number four, spies were deployed to keep an eye on them. Number five, classrooms were not free from such intrusion. The teaching and learning of history, political science, philosophy were banned. Foreign books, newspaper and professors could no longer enter Austria. Political meetings and rallies were banned. Press freedom was taken away and freedom of speech curbed. These were the application of the Metternich policy. Very soon, Metternich came to be known as the Prime Minister of Europe or the father of European conservatism. But in 1848, the Metternich system was brought down by the February Revolution and Metternich sought asylum in England. There were many reasons for the downfall of the Metternich. Metternich belonged to an era which was directed at nationalism, democracy and liberalism. He denied and suppressed the contemporary trend and attempted to cling on to the old system. This is where Metternich went wrong. He did neither plan nor strive for modifying the old system in agreement with the rise of new historical powers. As a politician, Metternich failed to achieve this. At last, the February Revolution of 1848 became the downfall of the Metternich.